contact the pastor. Pastor Chitinde, and we will contact the family. Pastor Chitinde, go and talk to them. You know, Brother Branham says, any boy that doesn't have the courage to go and face the family, there is no business going out with that kid. So Pastor Chitinde is a very strict man, very solid and very principled. When I called him, he said, send that young man here. I want him to sit down here and I want to examine him. So for the first time in his life, he had to get a passport, and his first international trip was to the Sunshine City. So they had their discussions, they spoke with the pastor, the family was called in, and we got a report that it's positive.
Amen.
Amen. So we rejoiced. But I said to him, it's not over yet. Get to know the sister. We don't believe in touch is a move. You know, at one time, Brother Branham, he had a girlfriend that he was seeing. Amen.
Amen.
And then in the course of them getting to know each other, he then found that girl smoking cigarettes. And that was the end of the relationship. Amen. So I say to him, get to know each other. Don't be in a hurry. Get to know each other. Amen. Because at that stage, when you have not made commitments, if that's not the person you were looking for, you have a right to pull off. Amen. So we gave them time. The sister had time also. Amen. Then after some months, they came back and they said, we are happy and would want to go to the next stage. They spoke with Pastor Chitinde. I also spoke to them when they came here. Amen. And I said, do you understand what we are going to do? Once you get engaged, you cannot come back now and say, but there is no more but. In Zulu, they say, ukhethile, ukhethile. Finish. Amen.
Amen.
So, when you come to this point where you make a promise, you can't go back anymore. This is now just one way. We are just waiting for the wedding ceremony. Amen. So, we appreciate what we hear about Sister Shai. From the family, from the friends. It's what we also heard from other people that we asked. Because Brother Branham says, you must be well advised. You must enter into it with your eyes open, knowing what you're doing. Amen. You don't ask for a vision. When God doesn't give you a vision when you are looking for a job, He's not going to give you a vision when you are getting married. You must get into these things well advised, knowing what you are doing. Amen. And just a little thing before we do the vows. So yesterday they were just